Good morning. It's Dave Herman on August 17th, 2017 at 11:16 in the morning. I'm going to do a 10-minute daily sketch of a walnut. And that should take till 11:26, roughly. 27, something like that. So let's just start out with an opening. And we're going to refine that a little bit. And we're going to just shape a walnut kind of crudely. Good. Maybe a little bit more there, and a little bit more there, and a little bit like that. Okay, take some of that, and some of that, and some of that, you walnut. And a couple striations there and there. Okay. And then we're going to kind of make this top a little wider this way so we can get something in here like the brain of the walnut. You know, walnuts are definitely good for your brain. And they have many different vitamins and things that we need. And they help you think in a special way. So walnuts are very good for the brain. All right. Now, the shape of the walnut brain. Let's just put some meat in here. We're going to go a little elliptical and come around like so. And then they're all connected, so we'll have another shape, plain, kind of meaty looking, like parts of the brain. But, you know, not as smooth in a organized shape. It is a shape that's actually its own shape, let's put it that way. And as such, we'll work it that way. It has a lot of these curves, and it does resemble a brain, but it looks more like you opened up the brain and shown the nice convolutions and all the lumps and stuff. And definitely good for your brain. Definitely gives you the ability to think in an organized fashion before and draw conclusions, they say. I forget what they call the exact word, but it gives you an ability to draw like a conclusion and take yourself to the next level of thought, like a pre-function. And so anyways, look up walnuts. They're totally amazing. I can't describe that and draw at the same time, unfortunately. So there's one piece, and let's put one behind this. So we're gonna kind of come up here. I don't want to draw right through it right now, but I'm going to create myself another walnut like that. And then the ridge is kind of thick, you know, tapers to that point and kind of opens up again. It looks like a mouth on a whale or something. Walnuts are pretty neat. And we're just getting another one in here. Hopefully we'll get to the filling it in. And let's draw another walnut over here. So we got one going like that. Just some shapes. Right now, a little bit of gesture drawing on walnuts. That's what I call it. Or my outline work to make walnuts look cool. And maybe a piece of walnut. And let's tidy this up a little bit. So we'll go up to 100 on our opacity. And we'll knock some of this stuff out of the picture. And we'll keep some stuff in the picture. And just make this interesting as I start to create a piece of art. If it conks out, I'm done. So now we're going to add a little walnut meat on the ground, on the table. So let's say it had a shape like so, and a plane like that, and then the meat kind of goes like this. Walnuts are funky. like that. And then another little piece of walnut, like so. Okay. So there's a good start. Next, I would add some striations on this, just to know that we're walnutting it together. All right. Now let's add some shadows, and then we'll draw in the walnut. So we'll go here. Let's pick a kind of a gray right there. It's a good color. Let's be very light in the shadow because you can always build it up. So we're at about 11 in our flow, and we're coming way down like 30 in the shadow, okay? And then I'm going to just gently build a shadow here. So I need a little more flow. Let's go up there, 37-ish. So put some pressure down. And we need a little more of 17. Let's go up to 30s here. Sorry, I had that backwards in my brain. Just rock out a tighter shadow before we build here. That's enough for the sketch, and then we'll get into some browns. So let's do that. We're going to go with a darker brown just as a kind of a light pass. Remember, this is just a sketch. And then we're going to change this to a lighter shade, maybe like an orangey, because they do kind of look orangish. And we're going to put some in the meat. 10-minute sketch, folks. That's it. Nothing too elaborate. We can always tidy these up anytime. But this is how to start a drawing. As always, I try and show how I begin things. And then if I was developing my walnut, let's say this one for fun, Let's get in here. We'll put a little shadow here to show that this is on top of the shell. And we might come down around here and indicate some shadows for some dents, ridges. You know, the back of this can be in shadow. And the front of this one can be over that. So we can kind of do that. Kind of show that the meat would be coming out here. You can come back and you can do a, you know, delineate a line or something that shows that meat that we're going to get back to. There we go. But that's how I kind of would build it. And just little by little. So I'm back into my dark shade. I'm going to continue coming out here and mustering up a little bit of a design. Here, here. So you start to see an organic shape coming into being. And there's some shapes there. Let's get a little more in here. You know, contrast is good. So you want contrast between your lights and darks. We're just developing a little bit here. I would really get in and, you know, like anything you do, you can really drill it down to a complex. Put some bluish gray in there, you know. You can go black, get a little black shadow going in there. Some darkener, or darken it up a little. and jump back and forth as you build it if you want. Now, some people like to just stay on one thing and do it. Me, I like to be creative. So